the idea of a seed landing in a spot and being adapted to grow in that spot for hundreds or thousands of years. It sees really cold days, really warm days, dry days, lightning strikes all around it, and it doesn't move. It doesn't budge. It's perfectly adapted to just keep going. It's almost like looking at the last 1,000 years of weather all encapsulated in one sculpture. My name is Brian Smithers. I am a research assistant professor at Montana State University in Bozeman, Montana. And I study forests and forest response to climate change. I do a lot of my work here in the White Mountains, which is where we're standing now. It's the westernmost mountain range of what we call the Great Basin. For forest, it's extremely dry. My overall interest is in species, individuals that live on the edge of what's possible. Trees are often living at that extreme. Here in the White Mountains, it's just the two species, limber pine and bristlecone pine. This is a bristlecone pine, Pinus longeva. They all grow in these pretty rough conditions, high elevations, dry forests, and they all grow for a long time. Bristlecone pine's famous for having individuals that are the oldest non-clonal organisms on Earth. We're talking upwards of 5,000 years that an individual can live. Key to these individuals' longevity is that they have really slow growth, so they've got incredibly dense wood, which enables them to withstand 100-mile-an-hour winds, which are common at this elevation. Insects or other things like rusts aren't really able to get a foothold in bristlecone pine because they just can't get into the wood. But the coolest thing is their ability to do what's called bark stripping, where they will just allow parts of the tree to die back. This is the patriarch tree. We're here in the patriarch grove of the White Mountains, and it's possibly the most massive Great Basin bristlecone pine in its entire range. And so it's been around for quite possibly longer than the entirety of Christianity, never mind Western civilization. We had one main trunk that was the tree until something pretty catastrophic happened. Looks like maybe a couple hundred years ago. But this one small branch right here stayed alive, and now that has grown to become the main part of the tree. They produce a ton of seed, but the vast majority will just get eaten by chipmunks or ground squirrels. Every once in a while, maybe one might just find a nice spot to land and germinate. But even those will almost certainly die. But if you live for, say, 3,000 years, all you need is one or two of those individuals over that time to make it. It is the definition of perseverance. It's why I got into these trees. I'm a community ecologist, and so for me, climate change is serving as a great way to look at how species colonize new areas. How do species compete? One of the predictions of climate change is that species will move upslope in response to climate warming. But a lot of these stands of bristlecone pine are already on mountaintops. And so if they have to move upslope to keep pace with climate change, certainly some populations of these trees will be lost. And so we formed a chapter, the Gloria Great Basin, which is looking at 29 peaks that we monitor to look at how the species ranges are changing or will change over time. So what we did is to count what's going on the landscape. We identified all the seedlings to species and then measured their distance from tree line. Our research has showed about a 20 meter vertical upslope average increase over the last 50 years. New individuals are getting established beyond the current range. This is happening very slowly for bristlecone pine. Versus limber pine. Limber pine is also a high elevation pine. It's long lived. And what we found was that most of that tree line advance is made up of young limber pine trees moving in. Those are all young juvenile limber pine. Cannot find an adult limber pine anywhere near here. And that was a bit of a surprise. Limber pine, which typically grows a little bit further down slope, it's actually jumping right over the bristlecone pine and charging up slope. Limber pine does seem to be able to take advantage of this rapid climate change, probably mostly because limber pine has a dispersal advantage over bristlecone pine. The Clark's Nutcracker, it harvests seeds from both limber pine and bristlecone pine and buries them underground all over the landscape. They very much prefer the seeds of limber pines versus bristlecone pines. There's this entire area of new undeveloped real estate that is now climatically available. Limber pine is just able to get there more quickly. At the lower end of the species range, so lower in elevation, that combination of warming and then effective drying, trees will die. And in fact, we appear to just be starting to see some of that taking effect. These are really slow, long-term processes at this point. However, every year is a new chance for young individuals to establish or not. And so we can make a lot of predictions about how the species is going to go forward based on what's happening in the last 15, 20 years of the young trees. As a species, they'll have to make some adjustments. Bristlecone pine has weathered many climate changes. They've been getting punched in the face their entire species history, and even in some ways thrive in the face of adversity. But whether they can make those adjustments in their range fast enough to keep up with climate change, I think that's the question.
This is Luke Groskin, video producer for Science Friday. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, then you'll love our other science documentaries. Be sure to subscribe to our channel, then join our growing community of supporters on Patreon.